We're now in the IntelliJ project for example EX29, which is in my live lessons Java 8 folder in my GitHub repository. This example shows how to combine the Java sequential streams and computable futures frameworks to generate and reduce random big fraction objects concurrently and asynchronously. It also shows the lazy processing semantics of Java streams and computable futures. Let's take a look first at one of the fields defined here in EX29. This is the max fractions field. It's set to 10, and it's the number of big fraction objects that will be producing and processing asynchronously in a stream. We now turn our attention to the main entry point method, which is used to get all the wheels started off in motion. And this will also demonstrate a bunch of the different lazy processing nature of streams and completable futures when they're used together. We'll start out by putting a diagnostic saying we're starting up, and then we'll go ahead and call a factory method known as make big fractions. And what make big fractions does is it returns a list of random unreduced big fraction objects. And it does this by using the stream generate factory method, which if left to its own devices will generate an infinite number of objects. And the objects we're generating here are the objects returned from make big fraction. Make big fraction is a factory method that takes in a random number generator and a Boolean flag. And it creates a very, very large random big integer as the numerator, and then a much smaller denominator that's random. And then it combines the numerator and denominator together and decides whether to reduce them at that point. In this case, we pass in a flag of false, so reduction will not take place yet. We'll end up doing that in a background thread using the common fork join pool. So we don't want to sit around forever waiting for an infinite number of these big fraction objects to be generated. So what we're going to do here is we're going to limit them by using the limit suppressing operator. And this will limit the number of big fractions to S max fractions. We will then go ahead and trigger the processing by calling the collect terminal operation, and we'll create a list of these random big fractions. That then gets assigned to our big fractions local variable here in the main method. We then print the list of big fractions. This is also done synchronously. We aren't quite getting lazy yet, but we're about to start getting lazy. So the next thing we do is we take that list of big fractions and we call the make big fractions stream factory method. And that's going to return a stream of completable futures to big fractions. So let's go ahead and take a look and see what that does. This particular method takes the list of big fractions, converts it into a stream. So now we have a stream of those randomly generated unreduced big fractions. And then we're going to call the map intermediate operation. And map is going to take each of the elements in the stream and call the reduced big fraction async method on it, passed here as a method reference. So let's go take a look at reduced big fraction async. The big fraction, reduced big fraction async method takes a big fraction and it arranges to run this big fraction in the common fork join pool to reduce the fraction. You can see what it does here is it uses completable futures supply async factory method to run this action, and this action will reduce the big fraction, returning a reduced big fraction. It'll print this out as a diagnostic and then go ahead and return the value. What comes back from supply async, as you probably recall, is a completable future to this big fraction. So this is running in the background and we get a completable future back to that. What comes back from make big fraction is a stream of these completable futures, and we're going to then go ahead and store those in this local variable called big fraction stream. And then we're going to turn around and print another diagnostic. Now, what this will indicate is the lazy nature of this. There's actually no computations that have started yet. The next thing we do is we take this big fraction stream and we call yet another factory method called make completable future stream. And this will be used to obtain a completable future to a list of reduced big fractions when all the asynchronous computations complete running in the pool of threads in the common fork join pool. So here's the make completable future stream factory method. This takes the stream parameter and it terminates that using the two array terminal operation, passing in a constructor reference that will make an array of completable futures. So we'll end up with an array of completable futures to big fractions, which are all the computations that are running in the background. And then we're going to use the all of arbitrary arity method on completable future to wait for all those asynchronous computations to complete. So we pass in the array of completable futures. What all of does is it returns a single completable future that will only trigger or only complete when all the completable futures in the array parameter complete. Then we turn around and use the then apply completion stage method. And when that gets called back, that means everything else is done. So we go ahead and take the array of completable futures that we created up here. We turn those back into a stream. And then we use the map intermediate operation to join all those elements. So what's happening here is we've got ourselves a stream of completable futures to big integers, which have now all completed. Otherwise, we wouldn't be here. So by calling join, we end up with a stream of big fractions as opposed to a stream of completable futures to big fractions, because we want basically the big fractions as the results. We then take that stream of big fractions and we convert it into a list by calling a little helper method called getListCollector. The only reason for using this is we just want to be able to print out the fact that the collector is being called here, and we're calling the toListFactor method on the collector's Java Utilities class, which makes ourselves a list collector. So that's something that's done, of course, inside the Java class library. What comes back from all of this, as you can see here, is going to be a completable future to a list of big fractions. And we then go ahead and print another diagnostic saying we've finished with make completable future stream and the collect method, and still nothing has happened. So then what we're going to do is we're going to use the then compose completion stage method to call another method called sort and print list async. So what this is going to take is it's going to take the list of big fractions that have just completed. And you're going to see what it does. It does something very cool. It's going to go ahead and sort that list of big fractions in parallel using both quicksort and using heapsort. So by using completable future supply async, we're going to quicksort and heapsort both of those, or quicksort and heapsort the list. And whichever one finishes first, then we're going to use the accept either completion stage method to either print the sorted results from heapsort if it finished first, or the sorted results from quicksort if it finished first. So if you take a look down here, here's print list. Print list just prints the contents of the list, which at this point will be sorted. So that's a really cool example of using completable futures to do things in parallel. So now at long last, we can finally get things to start running. So here we print off another diagnostic just indicating that yet again, nothing has actually happened yet. And then the join method is going to be called. And what join is going to do is it's going to set all the wheels in motion. It's going to trigger all the processing, all the streams, all the asynchronous computations. And that's when we'll see the actual results appear. And here you can see that we then finally print that we're done after join returns. So let's go up here and let's run this computation. And you can see what happens. So we run the program. So the first thing you can see here is that we start up and we print out the contents of the random big fractions that were generated by generate, limit, and collect in the make big fractions factor method. That's all done synchronously. And then after that, a bunch of other things take place where it demonstrates the lazy nature of stuff. We call make big fraction stream, we call make completable future stream, we call then compose, but nothing has happened at this point. And it's only after join is called that we go ahead and reduce all the big fractions. And you can see that they're reduced in a bunch of different threads because they're running in the common fork join pool. So they're running in different threads in the common fork join pool. And then the last thing we do is we go ahead and we sort the results using either heap sort or quick sort. And whichever one finishes first, we print the sorted results. So you can see we have sorted results of the big fractions. And all of that occurs only after the join call is made. So everything else is lazy up to that point, demonstrating once again the lazy nature of processing with streams and completable futures.